Thousands of crews are in Tulsa right now working to get power back on following those weekend storms.
PSO says for the Tulsa Metro, it could be as long as Saturday before the power is restored. That is an estimate, though. Wayne Greene from PSO joins us now on the phone. Good morning, Wayne. Let's get started right off the bat. How many people are still without power right now, and how many crews do you have out working?
Yeah, good morning, Leanne. I'm sitting here at Expo Square, and as we speak, we have about 136,000 PSO customers system-wide who are without power. The vast majority of those, 133,000 of them, are in the Tulsa metropolitan area. We've got more than 2,000 people from 20 different states mustering right now and getting ready to hit the streets. We expect to make big progress on this problem today.
That's great. You know, I wanted to ask about those folks coming from out of town. This has to be just such a heartwarming situation where these people are coming from as far away as Delaware, you were saying, to come in and help us?
Sure. Delaware, Pennsylvania, South Carolina, Texas. They're coming from all over. The mutual assistance network that the utilities put together is the backbone of the grid. No utility has the personnel to deal with a situation like this, so we all pull together when we need to.
You know, Wayne, we've had the ice storm of 07, we had this heat wave now, and frustration builds very quickly, especially when you're super hot or super cold, and we have just come to rely on electricity for everything in our lives. What is your message to customers, and when we go online and we see power won't be restored till Saturday, and we get into this panic mode, explain what that really means.
So, Leanne, Thanks for that question. We understand the frustration of our customers. We're frustrated too. The 700 PSO people who have been working on this since the storm subsided have families at home who are in the dark, sweating during the day. They want to go back to them. They want to solve this problem. Let me clarify what that 5 p.m. Saturday estimated time of restoration means. We're going to be making restoration on customers all along the way. Some people are already back on. About 38% of customers who are initially blacked out are back with power. We're going to make progress incrementally as the big transmission lines get restored. A lot of people are going to come back on. And so when we say 5 p.m. Saturday, that's when we expect the majority of our Tulsa metropolitan customers to be back in service.
By then. Okay. Well, Wayne, I wanted to ask about the weatherhead situation, and this is important. If folks don't know what a weatherhead is, it's the gooseneck metal conduit in a lot of homes where they receive power from the utility. So if your weatherhead is broken, you cannot receive power. How do you fix that? Who do you call?
Yeah, you need to have a qualified electrician come look at it. If your weatherhead is damaged, if it's pulled away from the house, if you have other damage to your fuse box, you're going to have that fixed before we can restore service to your home.
So that is not something that PSO takes care of. That is the homeowner's responsibility.
That's right.
So as we wrap up here, just I know that a lot of folks are wanting to know, you know, what they should do. Obviously, with the heat, with it's getting warmer each day, what are you all, in terms of getting people the care that they need, what should they do if they see a line down? What do they do if they still haven't gotten their power?
Yeah, so we implore everyone to be patient. This is going to take a while. This is going to be a multi-day rebuild. If you see a line that's down that has not been reported, please call our outage number and alert them to it. Most importantly, stay away from it. Treat it as if it's energized. Keep your family and pets away from it. Don't try to move it.
Okay, Wayne Greene with PSO. Thank you very much. We appreciate it.
Thanks, guys.